If Russia aimed a long-range missile like the Satan II it just tested, or North Korea suddenly targeted the headquarters for the U.S. nuclear arsenal, top commanders would only have minutes to get to safety.
If deterrence fails, we will deliver a decisive response. That's what we do. We have to make sure that we as the United States have the capability and we show the capability to our potential adversaries.
A senior officer at U.S. Strategic Command with authority to launch a counterattack if ordered would need to be able to escape a direct hit on the base and stay alive to advise the president. It's a nightmare scenario that is regularly practiced by the top commander, four-star General John Hyten.
That clock tells me you can always find the president of the United States.
Always know where the president is. In fact, the top screen on the left will actually list the location of the president, the vice president, secretary of defense, secretary of state, attorney general, everybody that we would need.
Then there is the countdown clock. Safe escape time, the amount of time to get to the escape aircraft via a secret tunnel.
You out that door and there's actually a stairwell that goes up to the grass that comes outside the building. My security detail will all have a car pre-positioned. I'll run and jump in the car. The roads will open up on this base and I'll go beeline straight for the runway. We'll jump right on the runway. I come out, I come right under the airplane.
On board the E-6B Airborne Command Post, Brigadier General Gregory Bowen shows us around.
We have a very small amount of time from when we get missile warning coming in to we have to have this jet off the ground and out of this area so it survives.
You could, if it came to it, talk to President Trump from this plane.
Yes. If it was the worst day in America's history and this was the only thing left, yes.
From this panel, intercontinental ballistic missiles could be launched from their underground silos.
The key's going here. And it's everything in the nuclear world is two-person control. So there's two people that have to turn the keys. The other one would be sitting behind you. And then I've got a switch here to actually enable the system.
And from here, using a classified antenna flying out the back of the plane, submarines hiding deep under the ocean surface could also get direct orders to launch their missiles.
We can communicate with our subs 24/7, no matter where they are in the world.
With the nuclear arsenals of North Korea and Russia now a top worry, this is the center of military efforts to stay out of war.
We have to make sure that we as the United States have the capability and we show the capability to our potential adversaries that should they decide they want to strike us, the cost of doing that is going to be unbearable on their country. And that's part of what this jet does. It is deterrence in its simplest form. If you shoot at us, your country's going to go away. It's that simple.